Hello, this is That Poor Clarky in collaboration with Prone, and we're going to talk about legal literacy for women. IPC 354D is the criminal law for stalking. It states that any man who follows a woman and contacts or attempts to contact such woman to foster personal interaction repeatedly despite a clear indication of disinterest by such woman, or monitors the use by a woman of the internet, email, or any other form of electronic communication, commits the offense of stalking. Whoever commits the offense of stalking shall be punished on first conviction with imprisonment of either description for a term which may extend to 5 years, and shall be liable to fine. Stalking could be in any form: physical stalking, stalking on the phone, or online stalking. So if a man is following you home every day and you have shown disinterest or you have not consented to it, then it comes under stalking. If he is repeatedly calling you in spite of you blocking his number or you showing disinterest, then that also comes under stalking. And if he is texting you, sending you messages on social media, commenting on your pics in spite of the fact that you have shown your disinterest, then that also comes under stalking. And it is punishable by law, where you can get imprisonment for up to 5 years and a fine. IPC 375 is the criminal law for rape, and it states that a man is said to commit rape if he A. penetrates his penis to any extent into the vagina, mouth, urethra, or anus of a woman, or makes her to do so with him or any other person, or number two, inserts to any extent any object or a part of the body, not being the penis, into the vagina, urethra, or the anus of a woman, or makes her to do so with him or any other person, or number three, manipulates any part of the body of a woman so as to cause penetration into the vagina, urethra, anus, or any part of the body of such woman, or makes her to do so with him or any other person. Or number D, applies his mouth to the vagina, anus, urethra of a woman, or makes her to do so with him or any other person. Under seven circumstances, there could be any of the one circumstances out of these seven. Number one, it is against her will. Number two, it is without her consent. Number three, it is after getting her consent, but you have threatened her or any person which is close to her with her consent because she believes you are her husband or any other man she trusted, but you are not. 5, with consent, but she was intoxicated or was in an unsound mind. 6, with or without consent if she is under 18 years of age. 7, if she is unable to communicate her consent. There are two exceptions in these laws. If it is being performed for a medical procedure with your consent, then it's not rape. And if it happens with your wife, then it is not rape. A wife who is not under 15 years of age. Rape in the IPC is not just penis vagina penetration anymore. It extends to anal form and oral form and object insertion, and the focus is on active consent, except in cases where the girl is below 18 years of age, that is statutory rape. Also, marital rape in India is legal unless the bride is under 15 years of age. The punishment for rape could vary from 7 to 10 years along with a fine, and it could extend in special cases to life imprisonment, which we will discuss in the videos to come.